Hello, I'm Olga from RubyMine, and in this video I'd like to show you how you can make your everyday work easier with inspections. So, what are they for? Inspections help you catch errors, enforce coding standards, and ensure code quality in your Ruby and Rails projects. We'll cover various types of inspections to give you an idea of the capabilities that RubyMine offers. First, let's talk about unresolved references. This inspection helps you identify references in your code to elements such as classes and methods that may not exist at runtime. An unresolved reference inspection might, for example, indicate a typo or a missing declaration. Let's have a look at my code sample. As you can see, greet message is not defined. RubyMine will highlight this unresolved reference, helping you fix it before it becomes an issue. Next, we have RuboCop inspections. RuboCop is a Ruby static code analyzer and formatter, helping ensure your code aligns with the configured style. RubyMine integrates seamlessly with RuboCop to provide real-time insights. We have a dedicated video on RuboCop, so make sure to check that out. Brakeman. It's an open-source static analysis tool that checks Ruby and Rails applications for security vulnerabilities, such as SQL injections, cross-site scripting, and more. RubyMine supports Brakeman inspections, which can help you find and fix the potential security issues. We'll start by adding the Brakeman gem version 5 and higher to the gem file and installing it. Now, let's invoke it via the run inspection by name action. If necessary, we can configure the Brakeman warnings in the inspection options section. For example, in the confidence level field, you can specify the minimum warning level that will result in report. Weak means you'll get a report for any warning, while high means only severe warnings will be reported. Now, let's choose weak and then run our inspection. Here are the results, where you can get deeper insight. Let's check into every weakness found by the inspection. If necessary, let me show you. It's possible to export the inspection results into XML or HTML format. With the ignore button, you can ignore a specific warning and add it to the brakeman.ignore file. And if you don't have this file, RubyMine will create it automatically. The skip checks of this type button allows you to skip all warnings of the current type and stop checking them when running the Brakeman inspection. RubyMine will add the necessary configuration to the brakeman.eml file. And again, if you don't have this file, RubyMine will create it automatically. RubyMine provides data flow inspections, such as type warnings or nil analysis. These inspections help you catch potential runtime errors by analyzing how data flows through your code. For example, here, title attribute is marked as an optional string that can either be a string or a nil. And because of that, calling the length method triggers the inspection, which warns us that this code may lead to a no method error. If you have a gem, add it to your gem file, but not installed in the project's Ruby interpreter, RubyMine will highlight it as a missing gem. A quick fix for installing it is available via the intention actions. RubyMine supports RBS, which provides type checking for Ruby code. We have a dedicated video about RBS where you can learn more details on how to work with it. One of the useful inspections is missing type signature. Invoking the quick fix in RubyMine will navigate you to the existing RBS file or create a new RBS file if necessary, and then generate a signature template. Other helpful inspections are for mismatched type cases. RubyMine warns you when you try to use types that do not agree with the types from RBS files. Cucumber is a test framework for behavior-driven Ruby development. RubyMine features a variety of inspections to help you work with it. For example, if you haven't defined a step, the IDE will highlight it. And with a quick fix, you can add the missing step definition. The IDE will also warn you if the background section is misplaced or there is a missing colon after the example's keyword. If your project is under Git or Mercurial version control, you can configure the IDE to analyze modified files before committing them. And here, you can select an inspection profile from which the IDE will run inspections. If needed, you can run inspections manually, specifying the scope of files that you want to analyze and the inspection profile that you want to apply. It's also possible to run a certain inspection via the Run Inspection by Name action. Here you choose the inspection you would like to run and configure how it will be executed. We hope this video was helpful. In addition to what we've covered, there is a range of inspections for all languages, and you can browse through others, such as for HTML, to see what's available. If you have any questions or comments, feel free to leave them below in the comments. Thanks for watching.